Hello folks, it's Barry here. Welcome to my Virgin Kitchen. Hope you're well. Today is another Sunday Funday video and it's the turn of mini food. You guys love the mini food, I love the mini food, and I've had lots of requests, surprisingly, to make a mini baked potato. And I was like, that's quite easy. So I wanted to do it a little bit harder. So I put it down on the baked potato posse, but we're gonna do a mini Hasselback potato. I've done a larger version of this before. Here's an image of one on the screen right now. Basically a baked potato where you slice it into little segments nearly all the way through and it kind of blossoms as it bakes. And I think it's gonna work. And I'm also doubly excited because, where is it? I'm gonna be using my mini cheese grater. I got sent three of these, so thank you so much for that. I will be using that later on. Without further ado, it's fair to say our mini food apparatus arsenal is growing considerably, and many of this stuff has been sent in by you guys, so thanks for that. I'm loving this pan, which we'll use in just a moment, and of course this hamper is never getting old, loving it to bits. We've got a nice little mini salad potato, perfect for our mini food plate, which we'll come to in just a moment. But first things first, we are going to need to cook some bacon. Now this is actually the thinnest rasher of bacon I could find, which I'm going to have to probably halve it and halve it again using a scalpel. Amazing thing about this mini food is I don't actually need that much bacon. So a lot of this fatty area, I don't want to keep that, so I can discard it and give it to the dog. And I'm going to wipe down this area, don't worry folks. So let's just get a nice little segment out of here. Like an operation or something, there we go. That strip there is absolutely perfect. We'll cut it down into nice little chunks now. There we go. Ooh, doesn't want to come off my thumb. Nice little segments of bacon, which we'll now cook up. All right, let's get this down on a low flame. It's gonna balance, yes, awesome. Little drizzle of olive oil, and then we'll just push in the bacon. Now, I do not think this is gonna take very long to cook at all. Time to wash the board and cook this up. And of course, our nail file is perfect for stirring these round, so I'm gonna get it nice and cooked through, then rest it to one side on a teeny piece of kitchen towel. So here is our potato then, and our clean washed scalpel knife. It did very well on the bacon. And all we're gonna do is very carefully, this is a sharp little blade on this thing, we're gonna cut nearly all the way down to the bottom in segments, okay? So you can see that pattern there. I'm just gonna repeat it all the way across. All right, and my last little incision on the end. Watch out for the ends if you are trying this. You'll notice my fingers have gone a little wet from the starch. Ooh, looks a little bit like an armadillo. The starch released in potatoes, like when you slice potatoes up anyway. Give them a little pat dry. So I've got another sheet of mini kitchen towel here. We wanna get rid of that and make it as dry as possible. Next thing we're doing is giving it another coat in olive oil, which is gonna nice and lubricate it. So roll it all around there. Encourage it to fall in the grooves as well if you can. So just sort of really work it in there. Not too essential at this stage, but get it in if you can, as I say. Giving it a sprinkle of salt. Wow. And then pepper. I don't have mini salt and pepper grinders yet. No doubt you guys will tell me where to get them. So now we're gonna bake this in the oven. Normally, you'd bake it without putting it on the shelf for a baked potato. Maybe I'll do a video on how I do a baked potato anyway, if you wanna see that. But let's see if it will fit on there. Maybe it will. So here's one of the shelves from my oven, and my potato does just fit on there. Perfect. So I now need to preheat my oven and we'll get it cooked and see if it blossoms. Super excited folks, because I'm using my mini cheese grater with some Parmigiano Reggiano, the good stuff, right on there, freshly grated. Wow, that's quite a lot. I'm also now gonna chop up my chives, because they're gonna go in there, and some other standard slices of cheddar cheese in little squares. Folks, I've just taken it from the oven, and if you excuse the pun, that is actually quite hot, but hang on. You can see the slices there. It's giving me a little bit, it's giving me a gap once it cools down to fill it. So just gonna show you with the scalpel and the nail file, we've got these little pockets that have opened up now that we can fill with our ingredients. So sticking slices of cheese in. And in goes the bacon. Managed to get all the bacon in there and a little sprinkle of our Parmigiano Reggiano. And we're gonna bake it in the oven just to melt through that cheese and finish it with our chives. Here we go then folks, straight from the oven is our Hasselback potato. The cheese nice and melted there. Let's give it a little topping. I just found some creme fraiche.
Amazing.
So a little bit of creme fraiche on top. Just a sprinkle of the chives on top. Oh my gosh, that looks amazing. Loving that height. And here, as usual, is a coin for scale purposes. I cannot wait to eat this.
Well, Boston, I would call this mini food a success. Down the hatch it goes.
Mm. Oh, God.
You smell it now? That is perfect portion control. So, another mini food success. Absolutely loving it. Any more mini food ideas, let me know down below. Subscribe if you haven't already. And don't forget to follow me on social media for regular pictures of pugs. See you next time.